A motorcyclist has died after the bike he was riding slammed into a power pole in Melbourne. The 44-year-old man was travelling along Portland Place when he lost control and collided with the pole. The sound of the crash shocking residents in nearby homes.
This one was quite loud, and then a bit of a thud and that awful screech of sort of plastic hitting the road.
Don't be the last statistic for 2012. Look after yourself on the roads tonight.
The motorcyclist was taken to the Alfred Hospital but died this morning. And overall, 35 people have now been killed on our roads this holiday season. 10 people have died on the roads in New South Wales, 8 in Victoria, 6 in Western Australia, 5 in Queensland, 4 in South Australia and 2 in Tasmania. Thankfully, the ACT and Northern Territory are so far fatality-free. Eager swimmers were keen to get back in the water at Sydney's northern beaches today. Dee and Long Reef were closed after a surfer had a close encounter with a 2.5-metre shark yesterday. Search and rescue teams patrolled the area from the early hours, moving two sharks out to sea before reopening the beaches. It follows an attack last week on a surfer near Port Macquarie who lost a finger. Disgraced Olympic swimmer Grant Hackett has reportedly launched Supreme Court action against his former solicitors over a botched prenuptial contract. Hackett had the agreement made before his marriage to his now ex-wife, Candice Alley. His solicitors made alterations to it in 2009, but allegedly failed to spot any defect in the document. Hackett claims the lawyers failed to ensure the agreement was effective, operative and enforceable by law. And a reminder to you at home, the Sydney Harbour Bridge will be off limits during the midnight fireworks. The coat hanger will close to road and foot traffic from 11 p.m. for 2 hours until 1 a.m. While it's closed, bus passengers will be able to use their tickets to travel by train between the city and the north. The Anzac Bridge will be closed between 8:30 and 9:30 p.m. and again for the midnight show.